He was a lucky man thus far. Paxton. Sure. He had a few conversations going on between his ears that weren't his. But there are worse things that could penetrate your skull other than voices. Fija used to tell Paxton, luck is a well, not a lake. Those who draw from it too often eventually find themselves thirsty. No. I see that look in your eye. You may disagree with me, but considering all things, the position that Paxton was currently in was no worse than being bitten from a few fleas off the skeever's back. Yeah, things could have gotten a whole lot worse. Hey, don't give me that look. It was a lot of coin and a lot of gear that we traded for this stuff, but it's worth it. I returned to Skyrim not long before you and I met with nothing. I mean, nothing. Trust me, that traveling merchant may have thought that he got over on us. But for where we're going, I'm confident that we got the better deal. I do appreciate you always looking out for me, though. Thank you. See? Even Jerry likes his new gear. Ain't that right, buddy? I could have done a lot worse than 200 glass arrows. And at least now we're dressed for the occasion. Black Reach is almost as mythical as dragons. A place so large that it covers nearly half of the landmass of Skyrim, but no one has even met anyone who has been there? I'm not saying that I don't believe it. I'm just saying. But Paxton, he didn't have to say anything. The cold north winds could have done all of the talking for him. Serana knew what lay ahead much better than Paxton did. She had just taken to the young man much more than she thought she would have, and didn't like to see him get a bad deal, even if it was a good one, considering the circumstances. They were lucky that merchant stopped at the frozen hearth that night. Cold days lay ahead, and even colder nights. Luck is not a well, but a lake. Grow too comfortable drawing from it, and the slaughterfish will poke its head out and drag you down to the bottom without any intention of ever letting you go. That's about right.